All right, here we go. Painting time. What's up, everybody? So I am about to kick off a little flower painting here. I kind of sketched a little, sunflower bud. It may not end up as a sunflower because I don't know if my sketch is what I want it to be. So I'm going to see. May go palette knife. If it starts looking like garbage, I might switch over to a palette knife. And we'll see how it ends. In the end, how it ultimately ends. So, hey, Rancorous Teen, what's going on, man? I think I checked out your stuff not too long ago. Good to see you. Welcome. About to do a little flower painting here. So, got a little AC/DC in the back, so I'm good. Makes me happy. A little AC/DC. I've been listening to AC/DC forever. So I was a kickboxer for a really long time, and this was my music that I used to play in my sparring matches when I was getting ready for a fight. When I was getting ready, you know, for fight nights, which we had up at our gym every Tuesday. And literally, this is the music that, like, I would get super pumped at. So this has a lot of good memories for me. A little AC/DC. So, like I said, we're going to start off with, we'll see how this goes, you know? We'll see how this little sunflower goes, you know? It might not go the way I want it to go. But that would be, you know, that's what makes it fun about watching me, right? Like, you could end up seeing a train wreck here. This is what I keep telling people. That's why you got to keep tuning in, because, like, literally, this could be a train wreck. So, anyway. So yeah, just kicking a little bit of paintings off here on a lazy, you know, lazy Saturday. I'm not sure if I'm gonna, you know, like it. Like I said, it's gonna start off as a sunflower, but it might end up as a completely different flower if it looks like garbage, or you never know. This could be such a bad idea that, this one just gets thrown in the trash. Who knows? I usually don't throw anything in the trash. So far, I've been pretty lucky that most of the stuff that I paint, most of the stuff that I paint makes it. So I'm not sure about today. So what do we got? Oh, Rancorous Teen. All right. Yeah, AC/DC's epic. Love them. Looking forward. Oh, yeah. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, definitely. Dude, like, I'm an AC... So I'm old school classic rock, right? Like, born in 1969. Old dude. But came up with Rush, Boston, Molly Hatchet, AC/DC, some GNR, but not a whole lot of that. Got into a little Tower of Power later, too. Like, Tower of Power's, like, smoking it. Tower of Power, man. My brother-in-law turned me onto that. And that is some good stuff, man. Some Tower of Power is tight. Like, their syncopated rhythms are so tight, it's just insane. Like, super insane. All right, let's have some fun. We'll see where this goes. So, I've decided to hit this with a little... kind of tinted my yellow a little bit red, so we'll see. Like I said, you know, this could be a bomb or this could be fantastic, but watching me, I've explained it more than once, watching my paintings are like watching NASCAR. Like, we don't know. we just do not know where the painting will go. It may go right straight into the rails and catch on fire and explode. But, you know, that's all right. You gotta take the good with the bad. You gotta be accepting of what comes out, you know? Like, being accepting of what comes out, too. Yeah, T.O.P. is definitely cool. I was into punk growing. Oh, gotcha, punk, yeah. Yeah, I didn't do a lot of punk coming up. My wife did a little bit more of that. And I stayed classic for a long time. I was a band nerd. So I actually, to be honest with you, I actually dug a little bit of classical as well, right? Like, you know, just a little appreciation for the classical arts, also the classical music. It wasn't always 24/7. Man, look at that. Jeez, I love that. That came out of nowhere. So it wasn't all classic rock for me. I'll be honest with you, I even some opera. You know, got a little commercial back there. Even some opera for me was good. I had an appreciation for a lot of music. Didn't do a lot of scream metal. That's the only thing. I never really dove into the scream metal side of things. And I don't know, just, you know, everybody's got their thing, right? So it's not right, it's not wrong. It's just like, where are you? What are you doing at that time in your life? So for me, I never really did the whole scream metal thing. Just didn't happen. So, I did some Kid Rock too. That's kind of embarrassing. Like, I'm gonna say, like, I did a little Kid Rock too. I don't know if that's embarrassing. Kid Rock's got some stuff though that it's kind of fun, you know. So I definitely did a little bit of that as well. Definitely like me some Kid Rock every so often. A little guilty pleasure on the Kid Rock side of things. So I'm painting with a big brush, right? And the reason I'm doing that today is because I'm trying to stay loose. Like, I found if I paint with a bigger brush, then it forces me to stay a little more loose than normal. So, definitely gonna try to stick with the loose, kind of the loose feel today, just to because I'm an illustrator, right? Like, I really only have been painting, like, not too long, for not very long. Like, I've only seriously been painting for 6 or 7 months, right? So it's not like the things that I'm doing right now I've been doing forever. I'm actually, like, you know, the only reason why I even get on here and, you know, do share these is because I just want to show people, like, look, I have never done this. I have really not been a painter my whole life, and I am picking it up. So I get on here to share, mostly to share a journey, right? Like, I'm just sharing the journey, man. A lot of this is, like, not being afraid. Like I said, you know, my wife and I, we owned a martial arts school in the past, so it was always about getting over your fears. I was a state champion, a martial artist back in the day, and you know, just getting over your fear of, like, doing stuff that's outside your comfort zone. And, you know, painting is that for me. Kind of outside my comfort zone. I'm definitely more comfortable with, like, I think I'm more comfortable with drawing. I definitely feel a lot more comfortable when I draw. But, you know, painting is so much more relaxing. Like, oh, somebody's here. Like, my drawings are, hey, yeah. Bae, I'm doing a live painting right now.
Oh, cool.
So, hey. Oh, my eyes are so bad. DeBarham Smith. I hope I said that right, because you were on my live the other day, DeBarham. And I feel like I messed up your name, and I felt pretty bad about that, to be honest with you. So I hope I hope today was better. I hope I'm doing a little bit better with the names today. Ugh. Sorry if I messed your name up. I apologize. No, but, you know, my comfort zone is illustration. So when I do paintings, it's relaxing. And it's definitely not my comfort zone, but I do enjoy it just because it is outside my comfort zone. I think that's why I do enjoy it. So, oh, thank you. I was actually looking for that brush.
Well, he was trying to chew it up for you.
Who? Dog? Good grief. So, yeah, you got to do what makes you uncomfortable. If you don't do what makes you uncomfortable, you're going to just, at the end of life, I think you're just going to be like, you know, wished I would have done this, and wished I would have done that, and wished I would have done this, and I don't know. I just don't want to. That is not where I want to be. Like, I don't want to be thinking I wished I, you know, maybe I would have been a good painter, and then I just never, like, painted, so. So I stepped into the painting world, and it's been pretty good so far. I've been fortunate to have some great people like yourselves jump in and say, what sort of paint are you using? Oh yeah, oil. So I'm using oil, but this oil is kind of like combined. Can you see the, okay, so here it is, check this out. So I use oil, but I get it real buttery because I use walnut oil to keep it kind of smooth. So yeah, it's oil, but I have a little walnut oil that I dip my brush into, and that's where you're seeing kind of that, I don't know, it's like super buttery. It's a real buttery kind of feel. It's a real buttery feel to the oil, because you can see that. You can kind of see how it goes on. Like, it goes on like super, super smooth. But I'll be honest with you, I also treated my canvas with walnut oil before I got started. So my paint doesn't fight the canvas. Like, my paint is not fighting this canvas at all. Like, it's just going on wherever I want it to, and it goes on really super smooth. So there's no battle. I have no battle going on here. It is just going on as smooth as silk. And just a little trick. So if you're a painter, then there's a little trick for you. Little tip, I guess, not trick, but you know. How to capture, how to get that smooth, buttery kind of painting feel. Not a big fan of how this is turning out, but But this was something that I was uncomfortable with, like this flower in particular. Kind of this sunflower. One of those things that's not in my comfort zone. So when it's not in my comfort zone, that's exactly where I go, is like outside my comfort zone. That's exactly where I'm gonna go. Like I'm seriously not gonna stay in the comfort zone. Not beneficial to stay in the comfort zone.
Oh, sorry. Oops. I'm so sorry.
Oh, that's all right. So I don't stay here. I don't stay doing things that I'm comfortable with all the time. If I do that, then I have regrets that I didn't try it. And that's what I don't want. Like, I don't want to look back and... I don't want to look back and be like, why did I stay so safe with that? Why didn't I experiment a little bit more? Why didn't I try a little bit more? You know? Could have gone further with that. Could have made more of that. Could have made a bigger impact. Could have changed the world. No, I'm just kidding. But it is all about, like, you know, don't always play it safe, right? Like, I mean, we can play it safe. A lot of people go through life playing it safe. I'm not saying that's wrong either, but not something I want to do, you know? I very much don't want to go through the world playing it safe. I do not want to be in the safe zone. If you find yourself in the safe zone and you want to get out, I found that I do good if I do a couple of abstract paintings. That moves me back into another place. That moves me back into where I make some calculated risks. Ah, Rose can. See? Is Rose Pujadas? Did I say that right? Pujadas? I hope I said that right. Rose R. Pujadas. So, Wops, what's going on? Welcome. Again, we're just doing something a little out of the normal. This is definitely not my comfort zone. Just trying to do some... trying to kick off a little floral. Like I said, when you watch what I paint, it's the fun part of it is you just don't know, right? Like... Literally, it could be a catastrophe or a masterpiece, and you're never really guaranteed what it's going to be. So, nice thing about oil is that it allows us to push it around a little bit. So if we're not really happy with, you know, if I'm not really happy with a color, then I can push the painting around a little bit. And that's a That's what I like about oil, is I can push it around a little bit. I think I've been on this too long. Tell I'm really focusing. I stopped talking. I really wanted this to look good. I wanted it to come out well. I don't know that it's going to come out as well as I wanted it to, but I needed to do something that I wasn't comfortable with today. And that is exactly what you saw, is that, you know, when you're going to try something, you may not always knock it out of the park. Like with this, I feel like I'm having a little bit of struggle, but struggling is good, you know. I think if I would have just done something that I know I was gonna really do well at right now, I wouldn't have grown. And I think I'm gonna go to the background because I'm spending too much time on these pedals. Spending too much time anywhere causes you to... Salvador, welcome. Spending too much time anywhere causes you to stagnate and stiffen up. So I can't be spending that much time in one area. That's a good, very good life lesson on top of a painting lesson. Get out and get uncomfortable and do some stuff that sometimes even doesn't make any sense. Because with that, you grow. With that, you grow. Cutting in this background is allowing me to kind of sculpt away a little bit of the what I didn't want to see. I don't know. What do you think, Irene?
Oh, yeah. That looks really nice. I like the color in that.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
You know, this one was a real challenge because the sunflower is so hard for me for some reason to...
Well, sunflowers are hard no matter what I think.
Yeah. I just think it's hard to find... You know, I don't know the shape, the where, you know, how is every single petal connected to the middle? I don't know, like all tough. So let me wave at a few people and wave and wave and wave and wave. Got my waves in. But yeah, this one is tough. This one's tough. Ugh. Not exactly the way I visualized this when I started, but that's okay. Like I said, this was an opportunity to be uncomfortable. And the satisfaction of not running away from being uncomfortable. Sometimes that's, sometimes we're like, oh, I wish I would have tried harder or put a little more effort into to the process or not giving up or whatever the, you know, whatever most people say. You know, a lot of people get really afraid to lose. That's the thing, right? Like, a lot of people afraid to lose, afraid to get it wrong, you know? They're running from, opportunity. Because opportunity is scary. And opportunity takes us out of our comfort zone sometime. And people usually at all costs avoid stepping out of their comfort zone. So by doing a painting that literally is making me uncomfortable, I establish a habit of stepping back into my own ownership, back into me owning my life. And not not allowing circumstances to dictate what goes on in my life. I get to pick what goes on and that doesn't come without bruises or bumps. Not saying that. Those choices sometimes end with frustration. But it also allows me to see where my limits are. Because sometimes we don't know what we're capable of until we do something that's uncomfortable. I did that with a lot of stuff. Running my karate school. Like, I was running a business in my 20s. I'm not saying that's phenomenal or fantastic or a miracle or nobody can do it. I'm just saying it was scary. Just one of those things that, one of those things that my wife and I were doing together. And I wouldn't change it for the world. We learned a lot. We learned a lot about, you know, business. We learned a lot about how to work with each other. That made our marriage better. But it was not in the comfort zone. Far from the comfort zone. So, hey, Courtview. Castillo, bienvenidos, everyone, welcome. We're painting and talking about life. Right now, like I said, this flower is a challenge for me. I'm not really a sunflower painter. So I'm trying to get as free as I can right now because I don't want this to be I definitely don't want this to be like I was trying to do something realistic. I'm trying to stay as impressionistic as I can while I'm doing this. I think if I can stay, see that little bit of blue? I think that just helped me. So I'm trying to stay as impressionistic as I can with what I'm doing. I'm not trying to make this a real sunflower. I just want it to be a fun flower. I don't want it to be real. If it starts to become real, then, you know, then my imagination doesn't get to have any fun. So, when I put a little bit of blue in there, like you're seeing, it just came out of nowhere. Then that's good. I don't want it to be real. As a matter of fact, I'm fighting really hard to keep it from being real. I want it to be motion and color. And I want it to be expressions of joy. And happiness. Joy and happiness. That is what I'm shooting for here. I am not trying to make a realistic painting of a sunflower. I am doing everything I can to make sure it is not a realistic painting of a sunflower. I want it to be something that is beyond that. Like an expression of, like I said, of color and a feeling of motion, I think is really important, which is what makes this kind of an expressionistic type painting. So even if I put, like, if I put like that, like a red in the leaf, or if I drop a little bit of blue into, see, look at that. See that? Like I think that's what I'm trying to do, like catch that. Like I don't want it to be real, and if I start to see it being too real, then I'm just gonna start putting stuff in weird places. And I think that's gonna keep me grounded. Because if it starts getting real, then I will have lost my focus. I am going to have lost what it is that makes me happy, which is movement and motion and that's why I like to paint, is for that, you know? Like, if I come in here and give a few of these, like that red, what do you think of that?
Oh, yeah, now it's popping.
Starting to really come out now, right? So I want it to move away from realism, because I really started to feel like this thing was turning into my attempt to show the world that I am a realistic painter, and that is not what I'm trying to do. I don't want this to be real. When it becomes real, it becomes tedious. And it's at that point that I'm not having any more fun. Like, you know? Hey, Marcelo. Itch sounds. Welcome, everybody. Let me get some waves in there. Thanks for jumping in. Oh, man. How do I get that keyboard to go away? Oh, there we go. Let me get some waves. Wave. Oh, I flipped it around. Ah, man. What a... Hold on. See, I told you, like, if you join in and watch me paint, it's like you could see a train wreck and I'm going to flip junk around and my phone's falling. Ah, man, all kinds of just terrible stuff. Let me see if I can get you guys in a little closer. My lighting is so bad, too. So, yeah, what you're seeing is an attempt to skirt reality. Look at that, blue. Like what sunflower is gonna have blue in it? Like, my sunflower is gonna have blue. Yeah, see, now we're talking. Now that I've added blue, since I've adding blue to leaves on a sunflower, that's when it starts to get interesting and fun. There's a little more red. Yeah, see? Like the more I break free of what I think a sunflower should look like, then the more fun this becomes. Like, I literally started enjoying this as soon as I started dropping weird colors in here. Like, weird colors made it better. For me. Weird colors made it better. Weirdness increased fun. What's up? I'm trying to check out and make sure I'm reading everything. Weirdness made it better. Yeah. Yep. Yep, there it is. There is the funness. Can I have another paper towel, Irie?
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay. I kind of trapped myself here. I should have brought the rollover. My hands are so super dirty and I don't have anything to wash them off or
here.
Keep them clean with.
There you go.
Thanks. Gracias. So yeah, guys, this turned out a lot better than I thought it was going to turn out. Like, I literally just, I've been doing these lately. I've been doing these live paintings of like stuff that I think is just going to be terrible. And they keep being okay. But I do pick subject matters. I do pick subject matters that really do make me nervous, and I'm never sure if it's going to be okay. I hope they're okay. I don't know if I am cruising for a bruising. With some of these, because that's what I feel like. I feel like also that maybe I'm looking for maybe I need a failure. Maybe I need something to go wrong here. So that I have a degree of learning and experience that I would not have any other way. So look at that. Like I'm giving highlights. Like I had some white on my paint and I touched it and I didn't know what it was gonna do. And it ended up doing something really nice. So many things could have gone wrong here. A couple of things did, kinda. I had to back up and I had to back up on a few things. Because it did go wrong. So I don't know. I think I'm getting close to being done. I think we have, what do you guys think? I mean, the lighting is terrible. Everything looks yellow. I'm sorry about that. Man, I was supposed to get some better lighting. I might do that today. Stop by like Harbor Freight and get some like better lights, because This light here is really bad. I probably just need to change those lights above me to a white instead of leaving them whatever they were at, you know? I think those were... See, I'm defining a few of these, right? A little, just a little definition. But because I don't want it to be real, like I'm defining them with colors that you wouldn't see in a sunflower, like blue. Liking this. I'm liking this a lot more than I thought I would. I've been noticing that too lately, that some of my paintings come out a lot better, even though I know I'm about to paint something that I'm not comfortable with. When it's over, I like it, and I don't know why. Okay, I feel like right now I want to see some purple. Nobody in their right mind paints a purple sunflower. Right, Mom?
What? Sorry, I was reading something.
No, I just said nobody paints a purple sunflower like.
Well, that's true, but it might have purple tones, like on sunset or an evening.
Yeah, well, that's true. But all of a sudden, I felt like I want to see a little bit of purple, and it works. Like I'm doing a little bit of purple tones, and it looks really good. That's crazy, man. That's insane. That's nutso. I can't tell if anybody's on here. I guarantee you. I guarantee you I am probably driving away everybody who thought this was going to be fun. They're like, ooh, sunflowers. I'm out. But look, it's not really a sunflower. It's like a Manet. It's like a Monet sunflower. Like, these aren't normal sunflowers. I promise I won't make them normal. I tried not to make them normal. Normal sunflowers could be boring. Little texture in that background. Gives it a little more character, I think. Ba-da-da-ba-ba. Am I done?
I think you're done.
You think
I like it.
You think I'm done though?
I like it.
Look at that. That's like a little bit of purple. I think I'm done. Yeah, Mom, I didn't want this to be too normal. And I think I succeeded. All right, guys. I think that's it. I think that wraps it up. What's up? Can't tell. Dina. Welcome. Hey, what's up? David Renault's on, Mom.
Oh, hi, David.
Miss Irene says hi, David. I'm gonna wave at David. Jumped on, just kicked off a painting here. Man, you guys need to check out David Wayne Creates. You guys go check out David Wayne Creates. He's right here. He's a book author, artist, long time, I'm glad to say long time friend of mine. So you guys need to go check him out. Like, his work is really good. Really good. Like, not regular good. Really good. My work is... I'm documenting a work in progress. Because, like I said, I've only been painting for about 7 months as a painter. As an illustrator, I have 20-something years. As a painter, I have 7 months. Which makes watching, again, why that is what makes watching my paintings. That's what makes watching my paintings fun, because I am no expert. What's up, Wolf? Wolf Mew joint. Rhonda Viveros is on, Mom.
Oh, hello, Rhonda.
Miss Irene says hi, Rhonda. I got nobody responding. I don't know if they're just on. I don't know if they're gone. I can't tell. I'm too new to like this. I just got a bunch of... I'm just trying to figure it out. So I was telling everybody before some of you guys got here, I was trying super hard not to make this sunflower look real. Like, I did not want it to look real. Like, blue, red, that's not real. That's not real. That's expressionism. That's me wanting to see a color in a place and having the creative power to do it. And so I just put it in. So, you know, this is expressionistic painting is about capturing motion. Some people will look at this and go, that doesn't even look real. Okay, good. Then I did a good job. Because I don't want it to look real. I like super failed if this thing looks real to me. You know? So, I don't want it to look real. If it looks real, failure. Like, the whole fight here was to keep this thing from looking real. I have a couple of my old students on here. When I say fight, they know what I'm talking about. Who do we have? All right, all right. Nobody's saying anything. You guys all still there? I don't know. You don't have to be there. Go and live your life. I do love it when people stop by and we get to chat a little bit, but I understand that people have lives to live. Can't be on Instagram all day talking to painters. But I do love when people show up, especially those people that I know and love and have had great relationships with in the past. I delivered a painting today, and I'm going to go deliver another one in a minute. After this, I got to go mail a painting. I don't know. What do you think, Mom? Am I done? You said I was done a while ago.
I think you were done, but I mean, I love what you've done with it so far. I always love what you have, and I always love what you
And you
have.
Like when some like new stuff comes on? Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, I never know if I'm going to, like, overcook it. Like, that's the thing I don't want to do. I don't want to, like, overcook it. I think if I get just a little bit of dark green in one spot, I'll be done. That's all I feel like I need to do. And then I'm going to call this quits, and we will have had another day of painting success. Because painting success has nothing to do with what it looks like, right? It just has to do... For me, it just had to do with, like, did I do something new? Did I create something? Outside the norm.